guys, welcome back to Wound Care Wednesday. If you are new here, my name is Lori. I am a family nurse practitioner and I do wound care as a specialty in the nursing home setting. Today's Wound Care Wednesday, I'm going to talk all about venous insufficiency ulcers. Last Wound Care Wednesday, I went over arterial insufficiency ulcers, so I will definitely link it up here. I don't know, whichever, I think it's this side. And also in the description box so that you can kind of catch up before you watch this video. What's the difference between arterial insufficiency ulcers and venous insufficiency ulcers? Arterial insufficiency ulcers are a result of damage to the arteries, and venous insufficiency ulcers are a result from damage to the veins. One way you can kind of remember venous problem is not a problem with blood flow. Arterial ulcers is a problem with blood flow. When you have venous insufficiency ulcer, it's a problem with blood return. Venous insufficiency ulcers are way more common than arterial insufficiency ulcers. Let's talk a little bit about risk factors that contribute to venous insufficiency ulcers. Vein dysfunction, trauma, previous history of venous insufficiency ulcer, and also advanced age. I think in the last video, I talked to you guys a little bit about how advanced age is also a risk factor of arterial insufficiency. Another risk factor definitely is diabetes. I talked about diabetes also in the arterial insufficiency video, because diabetes is one of those diseases that slow down three stages of wound healing, especially when the patient blood sugars are so uncontrolled. When I am seeing a patient for any form of arterial insufficiency or venous insufficiency ulcers, I also take a look at their blood sugars, like how are their diabetes being controlled? Because of course, the higher the blood sugar and more uncontrolled the blood sugar is, of course, it is definitely going to delay how the wound is going to heal, on top of the fact that they have some arterial insufficiency going on and some venous insufficiency going on. Let's talk a little bit about testing and measurement of venous insufficiency. Next testing that you definitely want to be doing on these type of patient, of course, is your Doppler ultrasound. Doppler ultrasound is one of those testing that is gold standard, and it shows us a picture of what the venous system is actually doing. You always want to check your patient for a DVT. If you see a patient and the leg is really swollen and you know you have the signs of a DVT, like swelling, warmth, pain in the area, we always want to assess the patient for a DVT, because DVTs can be a very life-threatening situation. One of the big complications that you can get for a DVT, of course, is a pulmonary embolism. If you suspect that the patient has a DVT, the gold standard that you want to use to check for that is a venogram. Another test that we almost always do is the ankle brachial index. If you suspect your patient has an arterial or a venous insufficiency issue, you do want to do an ABI on the patient. And anytime you do an ankle brachial index on a patient and the ABI is less than 0.5, you do want the patient to see a vascular surgeon emergently. In the arterial insufficiency video, I talked to you guys about how the wound typically look if it's an arterial insufficiency ulcer. So I'm gonna kind of quickly run over in this video what the venous ulcer would look like. Around the ulcers, you'll tend to see a lot of scaling going on. You'll see a lot more swelling in the legs. And a lot of times when you see the edema on the legs, you see blisters popping up. You do want to ask your patients about pain. When it comes onto pain, the pain is normally dull or aching, and pain is caused by peripheral edema that the patient is experiencing. One of the things you will tend to see is that the pain increases with dependency. In the arterial video, I did talk a little bit about position. Positioning for these venous insufficiency ulcers are typically medial aspect of the lower leg or the medial malleolus. For patient that has venous insufficiency ulcers, you tend to see dermatitis or pruritus in the lower leg. One of the things that you tend to see with these patients is a term called lipodermatosclerosis. And what this is, hyperpigmentation with erythema. erythema is redness, and you also see induration going on and plaque-like structural changes. Patient that has venous insufficiency issues, the pulses are normally there and normal. In arterial insufficiency ulcers, when I talk to you guys about the pulses, pulses are normally absent and you cannot palpate them. However, if you have a patient suspecting that it's venous insufficiency and you go to palpate the pulses and the pulse is not present, you definitely want to do your ABI, because now you want to see if there's some arterial issues going on and not a venous problem. The temperature of the leg in a patient with venous insufficiency is normally mild. In arterial insufficiency, I spoke to you guys before and told you that the legs is normally cooler to touch. Now let's talk compression, because in the last video with arterial insufficiency, I told you guys that these compression stocking and these ACE rods are not what you want to do for a patient that has arterial insufficiency ulcers. Compression stockings or ACE wraps are definitely okay with patient that has venous insufficiency that don't have any arterial occlusion. And how you know this is by doing your ABI and looking at the numbers to see if it's okay to go ahead and compress the leg. So let's talk about benefits of compression. One of the things that compression do is reduces pain in the lower limb. It also enhances the venous return. It also helps to protect from trauma. A lot of times when patients are in the nursing home setting and they're in like wheelchair, they don't bump the leg on a wheelchair or bump the leg somewhere, and it causing more trauma to that limb and then getting another ulceration that's going to take a longer time to heal. So essentially the compression stocking or the ACE wrap is protecting from trauma. Now let's talk about contraindication of compression therapy. Like I said in the other video with arterial insufficiency ulcer, you do not want to put compression wrap or ACE wrap, any of these, on a patient if their ABI is less than 0.8. Another thing that we need to look at, and this is sad, and I've seen this happen, you cannot just put a compression wrap on a patient and you don't take it off to assess the wound. This in turn will cause infection, because if you the leg with your ACE wrap or put your compression socks on and then for weeks you don't take that down to assess the leg, you don't know what's going on underneath there, because you're not taking it off and you're not assessing the leg and you're not changing patient's dressing on a timely manner. And I have seen this in a nursing home setting. Even in my documentation, I will say slight compression, like do not wrap it so tight the patient has no circulation. When you go to order compression socks for your patient, you want to know if a mild or moderate or severe compression that you are looking for. If it is mild to moderate venous insufficiency, you do want 30 to 44 millimeter of mercury. And if it's a severe venous insufficiency, you want to go up to 50 to 40 millimeters of mercury. Another thing that I use sometimes with patients is a dressing that is called Unaboot. Unaboot is a dressing that you wrap on the leg and it stays in place for 7 days. So what it does is it hardens. When you put it on, it is medicated, so it helps with the swelling and it helps with also taking care of the ulcers that is on the patient's legs. A little bit more about management and treatment of these ulcers. I think I said it before that dressing, there's no one size dressing that fits all when it comes onto your patient with arterial insufficiency ulcer or venous insufficiency ulcer or even pressure ulcers. It depending on what the wound bed is looking like. One of the big things that I tell all my patient that has venous insufficiency or arterial insufficiency is that they need to have patience. Patience is a virtue when you have any ulcers, but especially venous or arterial insufficiency ulcers, because these take a very long time to heal. I think that's it for this video. I hope that you did learn something. I try to compare arterial and venous insufficiency a little bit more in this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel, and I will catch you guys up on the next Wound Care Wednesday. Bye guys.